fans, University of Delaware and the NCAA have many traditions, but fast sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators isn't one of them. Please support the participants and officials with respect and in a positive manner. Inappropriate behavior will be grounds for removal from the stadium. Thank you.
Welcome to Hens All Access's coverage here of Delaware softball. As the Hens finish up their home schedule against St. Peter's, we'll have both games for you here as we head to the bottom of the first, and St. Peter's will hit first here. From Delaware Softball Stadium. Begin here slowly as Taylor Kretscher will hit first for
Kretscher
against Kelly Lupton. And the first pitch in there for a strike. And we are underway. Kelly Lupton brings pitch number two. That one's in there for strike number two. As Lupton working here quickly. On deck is Amber Velasquez. This one popped back behind us. Very, very windy day here. As this one's popped back again, the wind will take that away. The wind is directly in from center field. It's very windy. That one a ball now, 1-2. On deck, as mentioned, the shortstop Amber Velasquez as this one swung through and missed. As Kelly Lupton gets strikeout number one, one down here. As the Peacocks come in, they're 10-32 on the season. Delaware is 21-22 overall. And hoping to get above 500 as they head into CAA, their finale here this weekend against JMU, a big series as the Hens fighting for a place in the playoffs. And we'll break that down as we go through this broadcast. As you hear the wind whipping right there, it's very powerful. We'll see how that affects the game. As the 1-1 pitch to Velasquez from Lupton's fouled off to the right side, now 1-2. Velasquez, the shortstop, hitting 169 this season. As a team, St. Peter's 246 as this one's fouled back. Hens are hitting 269 on the year. But teams are hitting 361 against the Peacocks this year. So offensively, the Hens looking to really get things going here early as this one's in. Sigh, now 2-2. Have full coverage for you here today. Four cameras out on a windy Wednesday from Delaware Softball Stadium. Kick and fire, the 2-2, grounded left side and foul. We'll do it again. Two with one down here. this one up, and now 3-2. Full count now with one down. The pitch to Velasquez is up and out, and a free pass for her. Walk number 12 on the season for her. Third most on the team. So she stands at first base. And that brings up Nicole Omedo. The first baseman as this one's fouled back into the net. Omedo with one strike against her has Velasquez away from first. The pitch from Lupton as this one's outside. Swallowed up by catcher Danielle Wissinger. Let's set the defense here for the Hens. In left field, Shelby Jones. Gabby Klecko's in center. In right is Jessica Grisler. Across the infield, third base is Culliver. Short is Bensavenga as this one's lifted out and foul. So now two strikes against her. At second is Michelle McKinnon. Heather Oakley is your first baseman. The DP today here is Lisa Stasevitz. And as we mentioned, Danielle Boo Wissinger is your catcher. And Kelly Lupton, the start here today for the Hens. We see Kirsten Kaufman starting to warm up just kind of preliminarily here for the Hens as they get a little more work in. As they take on JMU this weekend in a gigantic series. As that went in for a strike, the throw tails away. Velasquez slides past the base but crawls back as Wissinger's throw kind of led Bensavenga off the base. So a steal for Velasquez. And now two down after the strikeout to Olmedo. So trying the strike him out, throw him out. But Erica Colon now hits as she fouls this one off to the right side. So two strikeouts here to start for Lupton. As the left fielder Erica Colon hitting cleanup. 260 on the season, 96 at bats, 25 hits on her year. The 0-1 in there for strike two as the fastball hits the outside corner. And so Lupton working here quickly is way up on Cologne. Outside, that one tailed away. Trying to get her to fish for it and does not. St. Peter's team has four seniors and one graduate as Cologne fouls this one off. Spoils a good pitch to the right side. And they are relatively local around the New Jersey area. There's a couple exceptions. They have a player from Wisconsin, one from California. Make that two from California and one from Vegas. As that one misses, now 2-2. The 2-2 from Lupton with two down. Looking to strike out the side, just not in order. This one's in, offered at, but not swung. Now full count. Payoff pitch from Lupton with two down. Cologne hits it to third. Culliver across the diamond. Oakley scoops it up, and the Hens get out of danger on the ground out from Cologne to third base. So three outs here in the top of the first. We'll head to the break. It's Grisler, Klecko, and Culliver. When we return, take our first time out. Coverage of Delaware softball here on Hens All Access.
enjoy an action-packed day with the Blue Hens for Fandemonium 5 on Saturday, May 3rd at the UD Athletic Complex. It's free for all ages from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. There will be live music, pony rides, food, giveaways, face painting, inflatables, games, and more. Stick around after the fun for the annual Delaware Football Intra-Squad Spring Game at Delaware Stadium at 12 p.m. Fans can also select a seat for their football season tickets at Delaware Stadium. All current and new season ticket holders are welcome. Following the spring game, the entire football team will be on the concourse signing autographs and interacting with kids in attendance. Check out BlueHens.com now for all event details and timeline. See you at the UD Athletic Complex for Fandemonium 5 on Saturday, May 3rd.
And welcome back. Bottom of the first here. As we mentioned, Jessica Grizzler will lead it off. The right fielder, then Gabby Klecko, rather. The center fielder hits second. Giovanna Culifer, third baseman, will hit third. Sarah Bensavenga, shortstop, hitting fourth. Lisa Stasevich, the designated player, will hit fifth. Michelle McKinnon, second base, she hits sixth. Heather Oakley is at first base, hitting seventh. Danielle Wissinger, the catcher, hitting eighth. And then rounding it all out, Shelby Jones in left field for the Hens.
Right fielder, Jessica Grizzler.
As Grizz hits here to lead off Delaware, as the sun has finally made its way through some clouds. As this one's inside for ball one. Second pitch now for Grizzlers, outside ball two. Now to Grizzler is low, now 3-2. And looking to get runners on base here for Delaware. Is in there for a strike. Now 3-1 is Grizzler. Looking to reach base here for the Hens and get on for Klecko, who has a little more speed as well. And then Culifer, as that one bounces up there. That'll be ball four, and Grizzler, there we go, walks for the 20th time. That is the most on the team. And nearly double of the second most, which belongs to Lisa Stasevich. And here is Gabby Klecko. Klecko hitting 298 on the year. And she a slap hitter. This one outside to her. But called a strike. A lot of movement here early as they're reacting to the slap hitting of Klecko, kind of offering at it bunt-wise, too, as that one's offered through and missed. Now 2-0, or 0-2, rather. Trying to get some motion, people moving, as this one's missed. Now 1-2. The 1-2 pitch to Klecko is swung at, chopped, and this will go out of play to the left side there. And this is all against the starting pitcher, Tori Fiorenzo, the junior starter for St. Peter's. This one outside now, 2-2. Fiorenzo on the season, 9.73. ERA, 0-5. This is appearance 18 for her. Gone 31 2/3 innings. Chopped to the shortstop. Thrown across, but not in time, as Gabby Klecko, an infield single. And advancing to second is Grizzler. After the ground ball to Velasquez, she could not make a play. And here's Culifer with two runners on. Giovanna Culifer, leading this team at a 374 clip. That's 91 tries and 34 hits. Squares to bunt, and the ball gets by. And so now no bunt needed. Runner advancing to third. And that was Grizzler to second. Goes Klecko. So Culifer gets set again now. RBI opportunities for her, has 21 of those, behind Grizzler's 22. The 1-0. Colifer grounds to third, freezes the runners, and across the diamond. Good play over there at third base by Sam Storms to freeze everything. And now Colifer out on the ground out. Sarah Bensavenga hits now. 273 on the season. 36 hits in 132 tries. Second most at bats on the team. This one's low for ball one. 142 at bats for Jessica Grizzler. That's the most. As Bensavenga has definitely gotten her tries. The 1-0 to her in there for a strike. Now 1-1. The 1-1. Grounded up the middle, past the second baseman. This will score Grizzler as the outreach glove of the second baseman, Kretcher, could not make the play, and Bensavenga gets the RBI single. And the Hens lead 1-0. Klecko had to hesitate, reported back to second before eventually making it to third, and now Lisa Stasiewicz has runners at the corners with one down and another opportunity to score for the Hens. This one's fouled off to the right side. And a strike on her against Fiorenzo. Stasiewicz, 250 on the year. This one bounces up, and Bensavenga will take second with no throw. So now two runners in scoring position here for Lisa Stasiewicz. Five hitter, the designated player, just to have a bat in her hand today, and that's why this one launched right at our camera there over in foul territory. The 1-2 outside, now 2-2. Launched over top of the second baseman, and that will fall down. This will score two. Lisa Stasiewicz is able to deposit that one down for a RBI, make it two RBI, single, as that scores Klecko from third and Bensavenga from second. And Delaware up 3-0 here in the first. Michelle McKinnon now will hit, as the senior second baseman hits 255 on the year. First pitch is low to her for ball one. Stasiewicz, that's RBIs 9 and 10 on the year, so double digits for her now. Three hits in the inning, three runs for Delaware. This one bunted at and missed. Now it's 1-1. Pitch is in there for a strike, but falls out of the glove of the catcher. Throw down to second. Stasiewicz is in safely as they're able to take a base away from Chelsea Cruz, the catcher, who drops the ball at the plate. And Stasiewicz now at second base in scoring position for McKinnon. McKinnon has 12 RBI. This one's outside now, 2-2. Looking for 13. Give Hens an early jump here on the Peacocks. Two-two. Fouled back behind. We'll do it again. On deck is Heather Oakley. Then Wissinger. And if we get there, Shelby Jones will round out the order for Delaware. This one is up. Stairs and a ball, now full count. McKinnon's just walked twice all year. Swings through this one and it is foul. Stasiewicz is at second. McKinnon at the ditch. Here's another full count pitch. Grounded towards second. Plays the second hop and across to first on the play from Kretcher. And now two down. Stasiewicz advances to third. And here's Heather Oakley. So two down. First baseman, Heather Oakley. Hitting 231 on the year. Leaves this one alone for a ball. That is 21 hits in 91 tries for Heather Oakley. The 1-0 inside 2-0. Leads the team in strikeouts with 22. As this one's outside. Now 3-0. Very selective here. And she's looking for her 10th walk of the year. Working her way back into the lineup. Becoming an offensive threat again as this one's inside. We'll take ball four. And now Danielle Wissinger will bat with runners at the corners. They call her Boo. As the freshman catcher hitting 239 on the year. With 12 RBI, as this one's fouled off her foot in the box, so strike one. So one strike to Wissinger, batting from the left side. This one inside and hits her. She swung at it but didn't finish the swing. Offered, but she'll now take the base, and they're loaded for Shelby Jones. And if I'm not mistaken, last time Shelby Jones had a bases loaded opportunity, I think you know where I'm going with this. Grand slam over the left field wall as this one's out. Side, ball one. That was in an absolute rout of UMES earlier this year. Shelby Jones gets under this one. It's not nearly going to have enough, and it goes out of play, too, for strike one. The wind is going to be nearly impossible to fight through if you're in pursuit of home runs here. Pitch is up now. It's 2-1. Shelby on the year, hitting 223, 112 at bats. That's actually third most on the team. So a very dependable nine-hole hitter, almost flipping it over, getting you two leadoff hitters as this one is outside for ball three. Swung through and missed. Now it's 3-2. As that went in there for strike three, Shelby not super excited about that one as the Hens miss a bases-loaded opportunity as a backwards K on Shelby Jones ends the inning, but the Hens bat around three hits, create three runs, but three were also left on. We head to the top of the second inning, where it will be 6, 7, and 8 hitting for the St. Peter's Peacocks when we return on Hensel Access.
A season of intense competition. Only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow!
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score!
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals. Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Bullseye! And we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
See a meeting on the mound here with the Hens as we get to the top of the second inning as Kelly Lupton goes back to work after striking out two in the top of the first. She'll take on Sam Storms, Crystal Carlucci, and Lee Harrison for the Peacocks.
Danielle for St. Peter's, third baseman Sam Storms.
First pitch from Lupton is lifted back behind us and foul. Storms 263 on the year. Three homers for the Peacocks and a team-leading 16 RBI for her. The 0-1 from Lupton is lifted over top of third, but Bensavenga's there to make the play. As a pop-out to the shortstop is how Sam Storms becomes out number one. Here's Crystal Carlucci, the DP here today.
Designated player, Crystal Carlucci.
235 on the season for her. 12 RBI is left the yard once this year. That one's in there for a strike from Lupton. And now 0-1. The 0-1 is low and inside, now 1-1. Foul back and off the post, you hear the noise there. It's a loud strike two. So 1-2 now. Carlucci takes this one up and in. Very close. She actually gave it a look back. But it's a ball now 2-2. Lupton continues to work. The 2-2 with one down. Carlucci chases. And the third strikeout today for Kelly Lupton. Now two down. Here's Lee Harrison, sophomore from Las Vegas, Nevada. And actually a transfer from Colorado.
Right fielder Lee Harrison.
So a two down, the well-traveled Harrison swings through the first pitch. Now one strike. You hear the wind again really picking up as that one is low. It's 1-1. Lupton set fire, the 1-1 inside. Now 2-1 with two down. As Lupton looking pretty good here against St. Peter's, who has a team struck out 222 times. Their opponent's only 135 as this one's fouled back into the net. Comparing to the Hens have only struck out 172 times. So that is 50 fewer than the Peacocks, who've had a real tough year at 10-32. As Lupton takes a little off of this one and it bounces up short, now full count with two down. Delaware really needs both of these. Fine-tune some things. Confidence important as they'll take on the best team in the CAA, JMU, for a three-game, very important series this weekend. 3-2. Lifted into left field. Shelby Jones tracing over, looking for the fence. Found it, but found the ball as well. Catches in foul territory, and the Peacocks go in order after the pop-out to left field to end the inning. We'll go to the bottom of the second. The Hens will send up the top of the order. Jessica Grisler, Gabby Klecko, and Giovanna Culliford when we return on Hens All Access. Jessica Grizzler will lead off for the Hens. She walked and scored in the first inning. This is outside for ball number one to her. Is back to work, Tori Firenzo, after giving up three hits and three runs. Actually leaving the bases loaded there in the bottom of the first inning. She'll work again against Grizzler. This one low. It's now 2-0. Grizzler, the unquestioned leader here of the team. Outside, and that went in there for a strike, 2-1. A well-decorated player. This 2-1 is outside, now 3-1. The junior will have one more year with the Hens. And she continues to try to take them to the promised land. As this one launched into left center field, skips past. As she's able to knock it down, Erica Colon making a good play there because that easily could have been extra bases. Instead, it's a single for Grizzler. And here's Gabby Klecko.
Center fielder Gabby Klecko.
Klecko singled and scored in the first as well. As Grizzler's single is the fourth hit of the day for the Hens. Grizzler's, or rather Klecko's, was the first. Well, she swung through that one. Apparently it was supposed to be a swing and, or rather a hit and run, or she's trying to protect the runner, but Grizzler not on the same page there. So now with one free strike, Klecko back in there. Leaves this one alone, now 1-1. One and one. Firenzo set, fire the 1-1. This one grounded over top of the first baseman, but foul. I guess that was a little more obvious than I thought it was. Hard to see from up here. So now with two strikes, Klecko. Going to choke up a little bit and protect as leaves this one alone. 2-2 now. Klecko's actually only walked one time, but this is her 59th at bat. Grounds it right back to the pitcher. Nobody covers second, but able to come over and make the catch is the second baseman. As that is Koretcher, who makes the nice grab. So a fielder's choice is how Klecko reaches second, or rather reaches base, and here is Culliver. Culliver grounded out to third as the first out in the first inning. But the team leader in batting average, hitting .374. She'll look to right that as that one's inside, ball one. Rain clouds have gone away. They were threatening slightly. As you see, Culliver protecting the runner there as Klecko takes second pretty easily for a stolen base. Klecko now on the year is 11 of 12 in thieveries. And so now Culliver will bat 1-1, but the runner in scoring position now. Pitch. Oh, wow. That one, a nice breaking ball back over the plate. Now 1-2. Firenzo's working a little bit better and faster here in this second inning. Any sort of pregame and into-game jitters she may have are starting to dissipate. But this is a tough matchup against the best hitter from the Hens. Outside, 2-2. You're just tuning in or want to rewatch this as many times, whenever and wherever you want, visit our YouTube channel, youtube.com/UDBlueHens. You can see an archive of any and every broadcasted game from this year, whenever, wherever, however you wish, whatever device you want. That's youtube.com/UDBlueHens. As you can see, both of these games, probably have them up for you later tonight. But you can catch the broadcasts against Hofstra if you missed those games this weekend, or any future or previous broadcast. This one grounded to short across the diamond as Velasquez makes the play there, but Klecko advances to third as Velasquez puts out Culliford, who's now 0-2. Here's Sarah Bensavenga, RBI single, and later scored in the first. Grounded foul off to the left side. One strike inside. That actually hit her. Thought maybe it was going to break away, but that one hit her. Second hit by pitch for the Hens today, and Bensavenga takes first. Stacevic singled home two runs and was stranded in the first, and now she'll grab a bat. She actually started that first at bat with runners at the corners. One advance to second, like we're going to see right here. That one low for a ball. And then, of course, she singled home two runs, like hopefully we'll see in this at bat. The two down. The 1-0 is low, now 2-0. The 2-0 is in there for a strike, and now 2-1. Stasevitz being very patient, looking for a particular pitch here with two down. The 2-1 inside, that's not it, 3-1. Three balls, one strike, two down to Stasevitz. Grounded right into the dugout off the facing, and that will be full count. Runners can't really go anywhere because bases are not full, so they will not get a jump. But a single will score both of them either way. And here's the 3-2. Stasevitz launches into this one. It will tail foul. And we'll do the payoff pitch again. Grounded to shorts, second base, and Retcher able to put out the Hens in the bottom of the second as a ground out to second base from Stasevitz is how the inning will end. We'll head to the top of the third, where it will be Cruz, Garonin, and back to the top of the order for St. Peter's when we return on Hens All Access.
You ready?
Chelsea Cruz leads off here in the top of the third inning as Kelly Lupton continues to work. First pitch is swung at and missed as the catcher hitting 179 on the year for the Peacocks. That's 10 hits in 56 tries. 9 RBI and actually hit 2 home runs in her 10 hits. So 20% of her hits are far as this one is fouled back in the net. Now 0-2.
You got gum? Are you around me? You got gum? Let me check it out.
Lupton has three strikeouts so far here today, looking for four, and the 0-2 is grounded to Culliver. Makes the nice one-bounce play, fires across to Oakley. And a ground out starts the inning. And here's Stephanie Gilronen.
Center fielder Stephanie Gilronen.
The center fielder hits ninth here for the Peacocks. But hitting 282, that's third best on the team. First pitch from Lupton is outside, ball one. And they'll go back to the top of the order. Corretcher hits next. And so truly in this situation, two leadoff hitters back to back. The 1-0 outside as Wisinger tries to frame it up, cannot, now 2-0. Carolyn Szymanski will continue to throw in the bullpen for the Hens. Probably see her at some point here today, most likely game two. The 2-0 bunted back into the screen and for a strike, now 2-1. As I mentioned, the Hens getting work here against St. Peter's. Want to win these because you want to gain some confidence, see what works well, continue to work on pitching situations. 2-1 from Lupton in there for a... Ooh. Apparently misses, now 3-1. But they take on league best JMU this weekend in a gigantic series. The Hens, if they lose all three, are eliminated from playoff contention. If they win all three, are guaranteed a spot. Now it's the points in between where it gets kind of interesting. This one lifted to second base, and McKinnon will make the catch, so Gilronen pops out to second. So here are the situations, as understood by our assistant sports information director. I'm being told to hold. All right, so we got a correction about the in if you win all three thing. We just can't be eliminated. A lot of the things are up to other teams, as I'll explain here. If you win all three, you definitely are helping yourself out. You just need some help from other teams. The 1-0 is in there for a strike, 1-1. So the other situations, if we're able to win a game against JMU this weekend, we need UNCW to win two against Towson for the Hens to make it, as the 1-1 in there for strike two. If the Hens win the series, so they win two games against JMU, then we just need UNCW to win a single game against Towson. So a lot of this is contingent on Towson and where they end up. And, of course, they're taking on the Seahawks this weekend, so we'll keep an eye on that one as the Hens are in Harrisonburg to take on JMU. Two down, here's the 2-2 from Lupton. Grounded foul, we'll do this again. So the best-case scenario is that you sweep the best team in the conference. But remember, the JMU Dukes were the only team to sweep Hofstra, who just swept the Hens this weekend. So it's a very, very good JMU team and quite an uphill battle. So you want to try to take one from the Dukes, maybe two. And then you need some help from UNCW to make your way into the tournament. A lot of that going on here as Delaware women's lacrosse is in the postseason tournament. Men's lacrosse plays Friday night. This one lifted foul, tailing away, and Brianna Sioka is our left field camera operator. She's getting bombarded already here early in this game. That one nearly hit her. The men's lacrosse team takes on UMass on Friday night. The winner is in at the four spot in the CAA tournament. Swung through and missed as Kelly Lupton gets strikeout number four to end the inning, as Corretcher has now struck out twice here in the first three innings. We'll head to the bottom of the third. It will be McKinnon, Oakley, and Wissinger when we return on Hens All Access.
Marry me.
Ew.
Troy Granite, we will help you plan it. We have over 2,000 slabs in stock. If your kitchen looks like an antique, we are open all week and can even finance it. Estimates, state-of-the-art equipment, we've got you covered. At Troy Granite, we all know that some rocks are better than others.
We'll get back here to the bottom of the third as Delaware up 3-0 on St. Peter's. I want to explain a little bit more about the playoff situation. The Hens are finishing up their regular season this weekend against JMU. There's a whole nother weekend of games to happen, so nothing can be finalized this weekend. There's just some more favorable things for Delaware. Winning games against JMU and Towson losing are two of those things. But then there's a whole other weekend of softball to be played for the CAA tournament to be figured out. A meeting on the mound between the Peacocks infield. And some high fives now being distributed as we will see Michelle McKinnon lead off. McKinnon grounded out to second in her only at bat here today. And they are, McKinnon steps out, now ready to go. First pitch to McKinnon in there for a strike. This one outside corner, now 0-2, working quickly is Fiorenzo.
Well,
0-2 Fiorenzo. This one launched right over top of the first baseman who did not jump as Almedo just kind of sticks a glove in the air, and it's a single for McKinnon. Heather Oakley will bat now. She walked and was stranded in the first.
First baseman Heather Oakley.
And the other one, remember, just the pitcher threw it. And she dropped it off the top of the glove. Carl was like,
Pitch. Oakley grounds this one right in front of home plate. Cruz fires and able to get Oakley at first base, but does the job, advancing McKinnon on the sack bunt. And now Danielle Wissinger will hit. So we see dust storm kick up there, and something that probably happens very often in softball, one of the bows comes off of an infielder. It's Wissinger. Now hits with one down, runner in scoring position. Up and out for ball one. The 1-0. Nail down the left, rather right field line. And foul. And 1-1 now with one down on Wissinger. Three runs on five hits for the Hens. And Lupton right now doing a good job of holding the Peacocks down. That's offensively not been able to do too much. Now one ball, two strikes after the last one finds its way in there. Fiorenzo, a little high on this one, it's 2-2. The 2-2, lifted into left field, backpedaling, the wind playing with this one, and it's caught by Cologne in left field. And so a fly out for Wissinger is out number two. Here's Shelby Jones. Fiorenzo struck out Jones looking to end the first inning with the bases loaded as this one's lined back behind us for strike one. McKinnon still stands at second after her leadoff single. Advanced to second on the sacrifice bunt from Oakley. Inside to Jones. It's now 1-1. One grounded to third, up and across, and scooped it first as a great play over there by Sam Storms, and the scoop from Olmedo will put out the Hens here in the third. We'll head to the top of the fourth where we'll see Velasquez Olmedo, and Cologne for the Peacocks when we return here on Hens All Access.
Enjoy an action-packed day with the Blue Hens for Fandemonium 5 on Saturday, May 3rd at the UD Athletic Complex. It's free for all ages from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. There will be live music, pony rides, food, giveaways, face painting, inflatables, games, and more. Stick around after the fun for the annual Delaware Football Intra-Squad Spring Game at Delaware Stadium at 12 p.m. Fans can also select a seat for their football season tickets at Delaware Stadium. All current and new season ticket holders are welcome. Following the spring game, the entire football team will be on the concourse signing autographs and interacting with kids in attendance. Check out BlueHens.com now for all event details and timeline. See you at the UD Athletic Complex for Fandemonium 5 on Saturday, May 3rd.
Kelly Lupton continues to work here for the Hens as we go to the top of the fourth. Amber Velasquez walked, stole second, but was stuck there in the first. Now hits for the second time. She is the only base runner so far for the Peacocks. Lupton, the 1-0. Is a ball as well, 2-0. In there for a strike, 2-1 as Lupton starts to crawl back here against her only walk so far. Inside now, 3-1. Three-one from Lupton is low, ball four. So back-to-back walks for Velasquez.
There you go.
Now Olmedo will hit. Velasquez running to second. She slides past the base and not for sure. Velasquez is safe. Umpire was right there. No questioning of a call here, but great job to avoid the tag, I guess. So another stolen base. So her at-bats have been exactly the same. Walked and stole second. Now here's Olmedo. This pitch also a ball. It's 2-0. Back into this one. It's now 3-0. Wissinger asked for time, and now we'll take this moment to go out and talk to her pitcher. Meeting on the mound is done now. 3-0 the count. Lupton fires. This one is hammered, but foul. Didn't actually make it over the fence. Now stuck in the batting cage. But a long and loud strike. Olmedo, who struck out swinging in the first. Now it's 3-1. Lifted into right. Grizzler finds it under it. Two hands for safety. And Velasquez tags up. Good throw. But not in time as Culliver knocks this one down. It'll be a fly out to right for Olmedo. The runner does advance to third, and this is the furthest the Peacocks have been runner-wise all day.
Fielder Erica Cologne.
Erica Cologne grounded out to third to end the first inning. This left fielder now will hit the runner right there. With one down, the first pitch. Launches this one, it is foul. Shelby Jones right on it, but foul, and now it seems like the Peacocks are starting to catch up to Lupton, and we'll see how she adjusts. Fire is in square, but did not offer at it. Cologne pulls the ball, pulls the bat back rather, and it goes high for ball one. The 1-1 is up and in, 2-1. Outside corner, 2-2. The call right there for Lupton. As the wind is just knocked the center field American flag silly. It doesn't even know where to go. 2-2. Lined right back up the middle, and the Peacocks are on the board. Their first hit, their first run, so the shutout, no hitter gone. All in one swing. And now it's 3-1. Sam Storms popped out to short to kick off the second inning. Now she hits way, way back in the box. First pitch, foul back.
That's right, I think she's got Sarah's stuff in our house. Oh, but that's right, it's your uniform in his house. Oh, okay.
One strike after the foul back to Storms. This one fouled back again, 0-2 now. The 0-2, grounded third base side and foul. So 0-2 with one down here.
Did you already eat two popcorn and a pretzel? You already did? Unless somebody wants to give you their snacks.
Line foul again into the bullpen. Take a look at the flag there as the wind is kind of pushing straight in. It also pushed right to left. Doesn't know what it's trying to do right now. The wind definitely a factor here in this game. Two strikes on Storms. The pitch lifts into this one. Shelby Jones tracing over and makes the catch. And now two down. The outfielders seem to be playing it really, really well.
Designated player, Crystal Carlucci.
I mean, the wind is doing something to it. They just have a good idea of what that something is. And they don't seem too affected by it. We saw Grizzler make a play. We saw there's Shelby Jones make a play. With not really much to it. Going on the pitch and sliding in safe is Cologne. After a breaking ball, didn't really get there in time to give Wissinger a chance on the first pitch to Carlucci. Two down, runner at second. Carlucci takes this one outside. It's a strike, now 1-1. We'll have both games for you here on Hens All Access of this doubleheader. Final home games of the year for Delaware softball. One low and inside, 2-1. Celebrated senior day this past weekend with Hofstra in town. The 2-1. Foul back into the net, 2-2. The 2-2 from Lupton is called strike three, framed up nicely by Boo behind the plate. And Lupton gets out of the inning with a backwards K, but able to scratch across the run, rather, are the Peacocks. One run on one hit. They leave one stranded. We head to the bottom of the fourth, where it'll be top of the order. Grizzler, Klecko, and Culliford. We return on Hens All Access.
After a season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow!
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score!
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Bullshit! And we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
There's Jessica Grizzler. She leads it off for the Hens here in the bottom of the fourth as they look to get a little more of that lead back as the Peacocks scoring one in the top of the fourth. One run on a hit for St. Peter's and three runs on five for the Hens. So we have a little bit of a delay of getting back to go here. It looks like our photographer, Mark Campbell, being in the dugout is not a big... It's not really that exciting for the umpires. I guess they had to move back a little bit. Now he's set. First one in there for a strike to Jessica Grizzler. Mark Campbell, henshots.com, trying to get as close as he can to the action without being on the playing field. Grounded to first and scooped up real quickly over there at first by Olmedo. And Grizzler out on the ground out. Klecko's reached base twice, but she's officially one for one. She reached on a fielder's choice in her second at bat, but singled and scored in the first. She right now, if the game were to stop, is the winning run. It's fouled back in the net for strike one. One strike to Klecko. Leaves this one alone, and it's now 1-1. The 1-1 misses. It's 2-1 now to Klecko. Culliford on deck looking for her first hit today. Bounce to the mound. Firienzo throws, and Klecko beats it out. Klecko absolutely scorches it across, and now stands safely at first. Culliford 0-for-2 today. She's one of two Hens to not yet reach base. The other one is Shelby Jones. Klecko from first, runs on the pitch towards second, no question, gets the stolen base. Now 12 of 13 in stolen base attempts, as the umpires will meet on the circle, not on the mound, but at the circle. And they are going to come over to the St. Peter's dugout here. They're going to talk and upset with the head coach. They're going to say Klecko left early and she's out. I kind of felt like she did, but didn't want to say anything. Not that it's even up to me anyway. But Klecko's out now after leaving early. So not a stolen base. So not 12 of 13. And that one is inside, ball one. So does that count as a put out? So it is an out. So that is a caught stealing, basically. So she's now 12 of 14 on the year. 2-0 misses as well. Now 3-0. So Cullifer, the best hitter for the Hens, but you got to think that she's going to make Firenzo work here, and she does, and it'll be ball four. Sarah Bensavenga hits now. 1-for-1, hit by a pitch most recently, but singled home a run and scored in the first.
First off, Sarah Bensavenga.
First pitch to her is low and outside, ball one. Six hits now for the Hens. Firenzo throws, and this is a stolen base from Cullifer. Nobody even covered. So there's the stolen base the Hens were looking for. And now a runner in scoring position with two outs. One. Firenzo pitch. Bensavenga launches it, but foul. One and two now after the foul ball with two down. The pitch. Bensavenga lifts it to first, and it's caught over there by Olmedo. So a pop out to first, and that's how the Hens get out of the fourth inning. And so one run out, one hit for the Peacocks, and 3-on-6 for the Hens. After four, we head to the fifth, Harrison Cruz and Gil Ronan when we return on Hens All Access. Welcome back to Newark, Delaware, as Delaware Softball Stadium is a great look at the clouds here that have finally cleared up. They were ominous when we were setting up, threat of rain, we were all kind of nervous, but puffy and nice now. Up and out, first pitch from Lupton to Harrison. As we mentioned, Harrison from Las Vegas, but a transfer from Colorado. So a well-traveled player, the sophomore, bunts, and Cullifer comes in, covers it well. And Chelsea Cruz now hits. Grounded out to Cullifer as well. But in the third inning, she's 0-for-1. With one down, Lupton delivers this one low and inside, ball one. Lupton, the 1-0 is up and out. It's now 2-0. Here to Cruz, the catcher. 179 batting average coming in. Has a double. Two home runs, though, is this one in there for a strike as Lupton finds a zone. Now 2-1. The one down, here's the 2-1 from Lupton. Hit over top of Cullifer and finds its way in. The second hit of the day for the Peacocks, single from Cruz. And now with a runner on, here's Stephanie Gilronan.
Center fielder, Stephanie Gilronan.
away from first. Gilronen offers at it. Wissinger pops out of the stance, ready to throw her out. That one a called strike. It's the wind now whistling. Bunted by Gilronen. Culliford from third is able to finish the putout, but a sacrifice advances Cruz to second. But two down. Top of the order now, here's
second baseman Taylor Karecher.
Taylor Karecher. Karecher has struck out twice. She's 0 for 2. First pitch to her is low for ball one. Strikeouts on the year. Karecher leads everybody. Pardon me, second. Has 26 on the season. 33, Lee Harrison. 33 is the most, as Harrison has the most on the team, is the second one in there for a strike. Now 1-1. Two down, Lupton trying to strand Cruz at second. Inside, now 2-1. Line to Bensavenga, who makes the grab. And now Karecher is 0-4-3. And the Hens get out of the inning as it's no runs on one hit, one stranded, and no errors in that half of the inning. We'll head to the bottom of the fifth. Stasevitz, McKinnon, and Oakley will hit for the Hens when we return on Hens All Access.
You ready?
Ready?
1, 2, 3, 4!
Lisa Stasevitz hits here, 1-for-2 on the year, or pardon me, on the day. Not on the year. The five-hole hitter is the DP this afternoon. First pitch to her is low, ball one. The 1-0 to Stasevitz from Fiorenzo inside and called a strike, 1-1. Late-breaking pitches from Fiorenzo have held the Hens kind of at bay, especially the right-handed hitters, as they often look like they're even going to hit them, as this one's popped straight up. Storms makes the play, and now one down. Michelle McKinnon, one of the two seniors on this team, playing her last couple games here at Delaware Softball Stadium.
Second baseman, Michelle McKinnon.
She is 1-for-2 here today. The other senior, Brittany Nunes, as they had their special moment on Sunday against Hofstra. This one low, 4-1. So that means of the starting lineup for Delaware, everyone's back except for Michelle McKinnon, who in this case is your sixth hitter and your second baseman. So the Hens, as this one's line into left field, the foul, are well primed to continue to build on what they have here. One and one with one down. Wind is really picking up, causing some time here. such a wonderful day that's getting marred by what feel like 60-mile-an-hour winds. Lined up the gut, Michelle McKinnon has her second hit. So two singles for McKinnon, and here's Heather Oakley. A win here will put Delaware at 500 on the year, 22-22.
First baseman, Heather Oakley.
Pitch to Oakley's inside, low, ball one. Inside and high to Oakley. Now it's 2-0. The 2-0 is low. Now 3-0. Peacocks have six more outs. Here in this one, if they want to get back into it. That went in for a strike. It's now 3-1. The 3-1. That one breaks back over. Just what we were talking about earlier. A late breaking pitch Oakley gave up on. Could have been because it was 3-1. Could have been because it was a great pitch. Either way, now full count with one down. Oakley fouls this one back into the net. We'll do it again. We'll see if the Hens try to get something cooking here. She didn't go on the first pitch, but McKinnon, with bases loaded, it's risky, but could get a jump. Doesn't look too prime to get going here, and now the full count pitch again. Oakley nubs this off the end of the bat. Storm across, and Olmedo makes the play. Sam Storms throws out Heather Oakley. Advancing to second, though, is McKinnon, so almost the same as the sacrifice bunt. Here is Danielle Wissinger. On deck is Shelby Jones, the only Hen who has still not reached base. You see the clouds have now made their way over here. Comes in sequences. It'll be bright and then it'll be cloudy. Inside pitch to Wissinger, ball one. The 1-0, Wissinger leaves alone and in there for a strike, 1-1. Hens sure could use another run here. As the offense has really slowed down. Three straight frames of nothing for Delaware after three runs in the first. This one outside, 2-1. A couple hits here and there, but since the first inning, just four hits. Wissinger fouls off to the right side. Now 2-2. McKinnon's at second after her single with one out. And now with two down, here's Wissinger trying to bring her home. The 2-2 outside, now full count. Wissinger is hit by a pitch in the first. We'll try to reach base here again. However she can, as this one's grounded to the right side. And foul once more. We'll do the payoff pitch again. Three, two, lifted up, and so full count. With two down, Here's the pitch. It hits her in the helmet, but she started to swing. And luckily, they're going to let her have the base. Right in the helmet. And she's fine. It's a catcher for you. As Wissinger's been hit by a pitch again.
Left fielder Shelby Jones.
Shelby Jones hits now with runners on. Grounds to third. Storms just steps on third, but that was foul. And so Shelby gets another shot at. So with two down, Jones swings at the first one. Now 1-1 after Fiorenzo misses outside to Shelby Jones. The 1-1. Jones lifts this one into the batting cages again. Now drifts out, but foul. So 1-2. The 1-2 with two down. Jones over top of second base. It will not fall. It hangs up just enough for center fielder Gil Ronan to make the catch. And a fly out to center ends it for the Hens here in the fifth. So one hit. They strand two. Don't score any. And we head to the sixth. And it will be 2-3-4. Velasquez, Olmedo, and Cologne for St. Peter's when we return on Hensel Access.
Marry me.
Ew.
Troy Granite, we will help you plan it. We have over 2,000 slabs in stock. If your kitchen looks like an antique, we are open all week and can even finance it. Free estimates, state-of-the-art equipment, we've got you covered. At Troy Granite, we all know that some rocks are better than others.
We head to the top of the sixth. It'll be Velasquez, Olmedo, and Cologne for St. Peter's as Kelly Lupton continues to work here for Delaware, who have a 3-1 lead. Seven hits for the Hens, two for St. Peter's. On the day, Velasquez has walked and stolen second base twice. She would go on to score the only run so far for St. Peter's in the fourth inning. Kelly Lupton, first pitch in there for a strike. That was the problem she had earlier. Did not start quickly or well against Velasquez. The 0-1, Velasquez lifts it up. Pass Culliford in front of Shelby Jones, but well foul. And now 0-2, Lupton way up in this count. So 0-2, we'll see if we can get Velasquez out for the first time. Into right field. McKinnon now tracing back. She'll make the grab. And a pop out for out number one. Olmedo hits next. She's 0 for 2.
First baseman, Nicole Olmedo.
Strikeout victim number two on the day was Olmedo back in the first. She then flew out to Grizzler in right in the fourth. Lupton's first pitch. Breaking ball falls short for ball one. Five outs left for St. Peter's to get into this one. A 1-0. Low again, 2-0. Follow the Hens on Twitter, twitter.com/UDBlueHens or on Facebook at facebook.com/DelawareBlueHens. Also find us on Instagram, search UDBlueHens. Now 2-1. Breaking ball falls short again. 3-1. Three-one up and out, and Lupton walks Olmedo. First time she'll reach today. And now here's Erica Colon, who has one of the two hits for St. Peter. She has the RBI, though.
Left fielder Erica Colon.
With one down, here's Lupton. First pitch to Colon is low, ball one. Three-one the score. Top of the sixth. St. Peter's with one down. Colon swings through, and now 1-1. This is the part of the order you want to navigate through if you're Lupton, because this is where the problems were created last time, as Colon was the one able to score the run on the RBI, as that breaking ball comes back over, and Lupton now has a 1-2 advantage on Colon. With one down, Lupton looking for the strikeout. Just high, it's 2-2. Lupton fires. Outside, called strike three. Wissinger popped up, but did not block the umpire from seeing it. And so another strikeout, that's number five for Lupton today.
Third baseman Sam Storms.
As we have two down. First pitch in there for Sam Storms is low. She's 0-2. Popped out to Vencevenga at short. Flew out to Shelby Jones in the fourth. Lifts this one. Well, foul. Foul back to the right side. Now it's 1-2. Two strikes now here to Storm. The 1-2. Lift into center field. Back goes Klecko. Finds it and makes the grab. And the sixth is done for the Peacocks after the flyout to center field to end it for St. Peter's. We'll head to the bottom of the sixth inning. It's the top of the order. Grizzler, Klecko, and Colifer when we return on Hens All Access.
Enjoy an action-packed day with the Blue Hens for Fandemonium 5 on Saturday, May 3rd at the UD Athletic Complex. It's free for all ages from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. There will be live music, pony rides, food, giveaways, face painting, inflatables, games, and more. Stick around after the fun for the annual Delaware Football Intra-Squad Spring Game at Delaware Stadium at 12 p.m. Fans can also select a seat for their football season tickets at Delaware Stadium. All current and new season ticket holders are welcome. Following the spring game, the entire football team will be on the concourse signing autographs and interacting with kids in attendance. Check out BlueHens.com now for all event details and timeline. See you at the UD Athletic Complex for Fandemonium 5 on Saturday, May 3rd.
Jessica Grizzler leads off once again. And this is actually her fourth time leading off. When Grizzler has hit, she has led off all day long, as that one's in there for a strike. And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter, to lead off every single inning she can. the 1-0, or the 0-1 rather, outside. It's 1-1. On deck is Klecko. Grizzle on the day, 1-for-2. She walked and scored in the first, though. Klecko on deck and Culliver in the hole. This one well inside. It's 2-1. Tori Fiorenzo continues to work for St. Peter's. Outside, it's now 3-1. See, Grizzler probably put the bat away here, even though she's the second leading hitter for the Hens. I stand corrected. Grounds out to first instead as Olmedo will put her out. And so now Klecko's up. Klecko is 2-for-2. Reached base all three times. She reached on a fielder's choice in the second. She's stolen two bases, scored a run, too. This one's up and out for ball one. The 1-0 outside, 2-0. As a pitching staff, St. Peter's is their best pitcher is Erica Cologne, a 5.88 ERA. Everyone else is north of 7 as this one is outside, 3-0. Fiorenzo actually was the highest on the team, second highest, with a 9.73 ERA coming in. Done a much better job at controlling the Hens here as that one's inside. And Klecko will walk and reach base for the fourth time. Culliver will hit. She's 0-for-2. Walked and stole second back in the fourth. That's the only time she's reached. And there for a strike to her. As holding Culliver down, the leading hitter for the Hens, has been probably the biggest accomplishment here today for Fiorenzo. As that spot in the order has been up with runners on, just hasn't been able to produce here today. We'll see what happens here. The 0-1 as Klecko runs to second. Tag is applied, but ball's lost. And a third stolen base for Klecko. Pardon me, second. I'm counting the one where she left early back in the fourth as a stolen base. So my fault. That's actually the second stolen base here for Klecko today. She's now 13 of 15 on the season. So 1-1 the count at second base is Klecko. Pitch to Culliver outside, 2-1. Two and one now with one down. Culliver hits. Could really use that insurance run as three more outs left for St. Peter's. And here it comes in the left center field gap. Klecko touches third and she'll score. And Culliver with a big RBI single. First hit of the day for Culliver and Sarah Bensavenga grabs it back. So Bensavenga hits a single, RBI single, and scored back in the first. Was hit by a pitch in the second and popped out to first in the fourth, so she's 1-for-2. Pitch low and a ball from Fiorenzo. 4-1 now the lead for the Hens on their eighth hit. Bensavenga grounds to third, storms to second, and no play at first. So Bensavenga on the fielder's choice, and that's exactly how Culliver is out at second. Now two down. Lisa Stasevitz will hit now, 1-for-3. Two RBI single. Two RBI single in the first. That was the big blow for the Hens. Still the winning runs produced there off the bat of 0-0. We'll see if those stand up here. As the 1-0 pitch to Stasevitz with two down. Lifted into left and foul. And will be a long and loud strike one. Yeah, DiRenzo gets this grounder foul to Storms at third. And now a two-strike advantage on Lisa Stasiewicz. It's 1-2 with two down. The 1-2. Stasiewicz leaves it alone. Now 2-2 is taking second. It's Bensavenger without a slide. So a stolen base for her as they're running all over the catcher, Cruz. Stasiewicz grounds to third. It is foul. Played well over there by Storms. Would have had a great opportunity to throw her out. But saved by the line over there at third. Two-two with two down again. Stasiewicz takes this one up and in. She was grounding the plate a little bit. And so that's a called strike three. Strikeout on Stasiewicz ends the inning. But the Hens able to get a run on a hit and strand two here in the bottom of the sixth. We head to the top of the seventh, final three outs for St. Peter's. It's Carlucci, Harrison, and Cruz when we return on Hensel Access.
After a season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow!
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score!
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Then we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Score update from across the way over at the newly renovated Bob Hanna Stadium. Top of the sixth, the Hens and Owls of Temple do battle, and Delaware all over Temple, 9-1. Crystal Carlucci will lead off for St. Peter's. Lee Harrison and Chelsea Cruz will finish up the inning as this one's popped up and fouled. And allowed. Strike one. On the day, Carlucci has struck out twice, looking and swinging. Into left center. Got a big piece of that one, and Klecko won't get there. It'll land down, and standing at second with a stand-up double is Carlucci, her first hit of the day. First extra base hit of the day for St. Peter's, and if I'm not mistaken, that's the first extra base hit for anybody today. Everything's been a single except for that one for both teams, so the first extra base hit for either team has Crystal Carlucci in scoring position as Lee Harrison takes the first pitch for a strike. Lupton, pitch to Harrison. Breaking ball is low, 1-1. Side now 2-1. Fouled off to the left side, now 2-2. The 2-2 from Lupton, fouled back into the net, and we'll do 2-2 again. Four to one the lead for Delaware. Final three outs for St. Peter's. As this one's up, now it's full count. Full count. Lupton trying to keep runners off because runners create runs. And this is ball four. Fourth walk today for Kelly Lupton. And now here's Chelsea Cruz, singled and strangled at stranded at second. Grounds to the pitcher, and Lupton across to first base for the sacrifice. Stranded at second. There we go. One down here, but runners at third and second after the Zach bunt from Cruz. And here's Stephanie Gilronen. And yes, is the nine hitter, but is also the third leading hitter for the Peacocks. And as I say that, she's 0-for-1 today. It looks like the coaching staff wants to do something different. And they're going to have a pinch hitter.
Pinch hitting for St. Peter's, number 11, Christy Kaniyuki.
Christy Kaniyuki will hit. So how do you better the third best hitter? You put in the second best hitter. She's hitting .316 on the year. 19 at-bats, 6 hits. So not a ton of opportunities, but has produced. Has 2 RBI in those opportunities. Here's the first pitch to her. Fresh off the bench, takes a look at the first one, strike one. So Kaniyuki has an opportunity to get St. Peter's even closer here, but that extra run from the Hens in the bottom of the sixth was very important. Inside, now 1-1. One and one with one down. Kaniyuki swings through it. Now it's 1-2. Top of the order, unless there's a pinch hitter. And it looks like there will be. No, pardon me. That is Taylor Koretcher, who's on deck. The 1-2. Swung through and missed. Strikeout for Lupton. As Kaniyuki, that's her 7th strikeout of the year.
Second baseman Taylor Koretcher.
So 2 down, Koretcher hits. She's 0-for-3. Big moment here for Kelly Lupton. Inside, ball 1. It was nearly there. Two down. Hens up by 3. The pitch from Lupton. Fouled off to the left side. Now it's 1-1. One run on 3 hits for St. Peter's, 4 runs on 8 hits for Delaware. And that one in the sixth looking very important here. See if Lupton can do the job. Breaking ball inside, just misses. It's 2-1. The 2-1 finds the outside corner. Now 2-2 down to their final strike. Koretcher against Lupton. The 2-2. Pop back behind us and we'll do it again. Two-two with two down. Once more from Lupton. Grounded to short. Bensavenga up and across. And we're done. Game one win for the Hens as Lupton gets the W. And Delaware wins it 4-1. For Kelly Lupton, that's win number 7. She's now 7-7 on the year. We'll take a 25-minute timeout. We will also not come back to this broadcast point. We will change links, and you will see that on Hens All Access for game number 2. For everybody here, we'll take a 25-minute break. We'll bring you game number 2, but until then, thanks for watching game 1. Hens win it 4-1 here on Hens All Access.